as I promised you, today I'm going to teach you how to design a mind-blowing book transition in PowerPoint. First, let's check it out. I know, it's been a while since I promised to teach you this design, but today is the day. I'll break it down step by step so you can design it yourself. Before we start the tutorial, I want to show you something truly special. I have designed a PowerPoint template that is so visually stunning. It is hard to believe it is designed in PowerPoint. With its dynamic animations, captivating visuals, and seamless transitions, your audience would think you have designed it in After Effects. This template is packed with more than 70 slides, including infographics, mockups, and other creative designs. I have designed 4 different templates, and one of them is with shadow, which adds a realistic touch to your slides. If you want to impress your audience, you can download this template in the description. Now let's dive in and design this stunning book transition together. Let's start by adding a picture as background. From Insert tab, click on Pictures and insert it from this device. Now draw a rectangle. Set its height to 7.5 and width to 6.6. Put it in this position, then right-click on it and choose Format Shape. In this window, click on Picture or Texture Fill and insert your picture as a texture. Let's remove its outline. Now go to the 3D format part and add top bevel to the shape. From Shape menu, select the block arc and draw it. Set its diameter to 0.5. Change its color to black and remove its outline. Drag this yellow dot to decrease its thickness and this one to increase the amount of arc. Let me open the Format Shape window. In the 3D rotation part, rotate the Y value to 70 degrees. Go to the 3D format part and increase the size of depth and contour to 0.5. Let me change the contour color to this gray. Now duplicate the shape and draw a square. Set its height and width to 0.2. Let's adjust them like this. Select these two and bring them to the front. If you want, you can adjust the size of the arc by dragging this yellow dot. Anyway, select the S-square and by using the eyedropper tool, choose the background color for it. Remove its outline and open the Format Shape window. Add an inner shadow in this direction to the shape and decrease its transparency to 30%. Hold the Ctrl key down, select these 3 shapes, and by pressing Ctrl G, group them. Now select the group and press Ctrl D 15 times. Drag the last one to this position. Let me zoom in to adjust it precisely. You can use the arrow keys to move it slightly. Now select all the groups and align them to the left. And then choose Distribute Vertically from the menu. It is better to press Ctrl G to group them. Okay, the first part is ready. Let me drag this a little bit to this side. Better. Duplicate the slide, then hold the Ctrl key down and make a copy of this shape on this side. If it is hard for you to adjust it exactly to this position, drag it to this area and align it to the left and top. Now select the frame and bring it to the front. First, ungroup them, then hold the Ctrl key down and deselect the first one. Now you can delete the rest of them. Let's zoom in and ungroup it. Hold the Ctrl and Shift keys down and make a copy of the square. Rotate it horizontally to change the direction of the shadow. Select these two and bring them to the front. Now select this shape, then drag this yellow dot to the half. Repeat this for the other shape. Adjust them like this, then select all of them and group them. I think you know what should you do now, don't you? Select the group and press Ctrl D 15 times. Drag the last one here and align it to the center. Select all of them. Align them to the left and choose Distribute Vertically from the menu. Let's group them. Draw a rectangle and adjust it like this. If you are not sure it is in the middle, align it to the middle. Change its color and remove its outline. Draw a rounded rectangle and make it fully rounded. Let's put it in this position. Select the rectangle first, then this shape. Go to the Shape Format tab, and in the Merge Shape section, choose Subtract. Let me open the Format Shape window and add a drop shadow in this direction to it. Set the blur amount to 25 and distance to 12. Draw a rectangle. Select both shapes, align them to the bottom and right. Now select the wireframe and this rectangle and bring them to the front. Add a text box and type the page number. Hold the Shift key down and rotate it 90 degrees. Put it in this position, then select these three items and by pressing Ctrl G group them. I think we need to bring the frame to the top. Okay, the second slide is ready. Let's duplicate it. Select this group, then hold the Ctrl and Shift keys down and make a copy of it. Now rotate it horizontally. Let me adjust it, then select the text box inside the group and rotate it horizontally to fix it. Now bring the frame to the top. Alright, this slide is ready. To design the last slide, we have to duplicate the first slide and drag it down. For the background, you can use another picture or rotate this one horizontally and put it to this position. Hold the Shift key down and drag this shape to this side. Select the frame, rotate it horizontally, and adjust it like this. If you like, you can change the cover of book. To do that, select the cover, then from Picture Format tab, change it from this device. Now use the Format Painter tool and apply it to the first slide. There are four lines on the border of book and select all of them. Change their color, increase the thickness, and change the dash type. Now open the Format Shape window. Add a center shadow to them with 0% transparency. Let's increase their transparency to 40%. Alright, copy and paste them into the last slide. It is time to add your information for each page. At the end, select these slides and add page curl transition to them.
I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a big thumb up. And if you haven't subscribed to the channel, please consider subscribing. Alright, I'll see you next video.